Of course,
Hello.
your friend.
Hi, babes. Hi, friend. You want to
Nice.
be a part of this? Okay, yes. Make yourself comfortable.
Wow.
Belly rubs, really. Hi, Muthoni here.
What's up, it's Nick and Bruno. High-fiving.
It's raining outside. Today's video, actually, we wanted to shoot outside. But it's raining, so. But before we even get started on the video, we just hit 10k subscribers!
10k subscribers! Yay! That's what's up! Shoutouts to you, subscriber!
Thank you! And also, Nili noticed something that apparently you like being called out, so I'm gonna call you out again. If you are watching our videos, you come back every Thursday, every Monday, you come back, you take your time, you even know. The upload time. Paka unanitumianga DM. Uko like, ah, madam, it is 3 PM. Where is our video? You know yourself. Na hauja subscribe.
Shame on you. You had better subscribe ASAP. ASAP.
What are you waiting for? You're already a member of the family by all other protocols that are observed. But hujafanya the thing. Eh? Even Bruno. Paka Bruno amesimama ameshtuka. It's like you have... No, mwangalia kule side. Kule side. Eh? Imagine. Subscribe. Because subscribing does help our channel. Na usisahau kuacha comment. Juu umependezwa sana na hii video. Na usisahau kufanya a thumbs up. Kutuambia umependezwa sana na hii video. So we can keep making more of these videos. So today's video is about attachment styles. So,
what's that?
Apparently it's like how...
Bless you.
So, the timeline has been crazy on Twitter, where people are like now talking about their attachment styles, and they've discovered their attachment styles. And we are going to explain what attachment styles are, and then we are going to take the test. It's like
a test.
Quiz. There's this online spaces, online platforms where you can take a quiz that tells you.
What your
attachment
is. Is it like a personality trait thing?
Not really. It's about like how you carry yourself in a relationship and what category you might fall under.
Okay.
So, as you know, Mimi, I don't like the whole... I don't think anyone... Like, you can only be just one thing. I never believe that you can only be one thing. So, even with this, just putting it out there. Even if they say you are one thing, you might have traits that fall under a different category. Or category. we're just curious. We want to see what it says about us and how we carry ourselves in relationships and such and stuff like that.
But it
doesn't mean that this is set on stone. And also, I think that things can change. Because even me, I think the way I am in this relationship now is not how I have been in relationships before. So I guess even like with the attachment style thing, it's something that can change. The same way like those personality tests. The other one is called what? The other one. For love languages.
Oh.
Yeah. Sorry. Love languages. I don't think you can just be one thing. I think it's very hard to put human beings in just one box and say. I think it's because people are so used to putting people in boxes that it's very important for them for you to fit into a box.
Yeah.
So even like there's people who will like ask me questions of what's my whatever, what is it called? Sidri personality, whatever. Those ones where Sidri
your
ENJ, whatever.
Oh,
no, those are the ones. Where it's like Sidri EN, what? Yeah, I can take a test and it says, oh, this is what you are. But I'm not going to live my life based off of what that
you can't use that to like say that's the reason why you make the
yes
do life the way
the
you
way
do
I
it.
Do exactly because for me I
Fair
think
enough.
I do life and also the way we do life is influenced by other things, people you're around. There's people who are very different when they are around a different crowd, like if you are surrounded, like for you when you're around actors versus when you're around say your family members, you might behave differently. Because even like the kind of conversations that I had, like there's people when they're with their family, they're like, even your family does not know you make jokes. You get? Then you go and you're there with your friends.
And you're the life of the party.
You know, so for me, I think.
And I think that's a cool
thing.
That's what makes being human a good thing. You should be able to be different, be a
different
person
with
around different people.
Yeah. It's it's all fun. Mm-hmm. It's about having fun moments and enjoying things. And also just seeing what this scientist, because they do claim they are scientifically proven, but I'm like, yeah. Me, I don't see any studies underneath them saying we have whatever. Because also, most of these studies are only done abroad. Completely different environment from us. The way they do their lives is completely different from us. So I'm like, a scientist in Minnesota, I know it's Minnesota, but I don't care. A scientist in Minnesota is not going to tell me that me here in Nairobi, the reason I climb a tree is because I am seeking attention. I could be climbing because I am building a treehouse. Or I am going to pick new tree tomatoes. Yes, fruits. So, you get what I mean? Yeah, I'm just going attachment style quiz. I'm literally just going to Google, and then the first one that pops up is probably the one I'll pick. So this one is, there's one website here called The Science of People. I don't know. Do I like that? We're going to pick the one we like. The second website here is called Psychology Today. And then the other one is...
Can't go wrong with Psychology
Today. Diane Paul Heller. We'll go with Psychology. It's in the middle. Let's see. I hope it's
69%.
Like... Okay, so... you're talking a lot. Okay. You will then have the option to purchase full results at $6.95. Okay, so the first thing they have here is a description of what it is. It even has a table of contents. But let's just do the description. It says, attachment styles describe our tendencies and patterns of how we connect to the people in our lives. Take the quiz to find out your attachment style! Exclamation mark. That's the rain. I just wanted to give you ambiance.
And the weather forecast says it's going to rain until tomorrow.
It still looks pretty when it rains.
It's going to rain until tomorrow.
That's okay.
It's 1 p.m.
That's okay. Are you going anywhere?
Yes.
You're going somewhere?
Inside.
So we're going to take the test. It's a quiz, rather. So you just answer questions. And then we're going to now discuss what it tells us.
Discover your own personal attachment style by taking this short quiz.
Oh, that's all they were saying. Okay. They first want to know our names. Okay.
Both
okay, names? The site... I'm just putting one in. We'll leave the link to this particular quiz in the comments in the description box if anyone is interested in taking it. If you want to share with us what your attachment style is as well. We finished the test, the quiz. I don't like the word test. Mm-hmm. We finished the quiz. Nick is gonna go first.
So I have to read all this?
Just what it says about, it says what your attachment personality is and what it says as a description.
So mine says your attachment personality is anxious. Okay. People who anxiously attach tend to worry more about their relationships. They are said to experience an emotional hunger and are desperate for a fantasy type of love. Unlike securely attached people, people with an anxious attachment tend to be desperate to form a fantasy bond of ideal love, even when this might not be possible or reciprocated. They tend to look for a partner who can rescue them or complete them. Unfortunately, their desperation sometimes can push away the exact person they want closeness with. When they are afraid of losing their partner, they become clingy, possessive, paranoid, and need constant attention.
That's so interesting. So mine says that my attachment personality is secure.
Secure.
Yeah, so here it says, securely attached people tend to be less anxious and more satisfied with their relationships. Securely attached people have an easy time forming connections and have less doubt about the equality of the relationship. They also have an easier time reaching out for comfort. That's all they say.
Wow, it's so short.
I know. Cool. I was like, when you're saying, I have to read all of this, I was like, all of what? It's just a short statement.
I guess it's because anxious people have problems.
No, but do you believe that it's
yes, accurate? A lot of it is very accurate, mm-hmm. especially over the last couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Just because in the last couple of weeks I've had to think a lot about myself and the relationship, and yes, there are a lot of things that have been said here that are like, yeah, that kind of makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
I can see why I would be considered that. Yeah.
And do you think it's also a reflection, because you just said in the last couple of weeks, what about, like, because it says current or previous partners, yeah, so do you think generally it sums you up in a relationship?
Certain parts, not everything, but mm-hmm. there are things that I can see how
mm-hmm.
I can fall into that category.
Yeah.
Yeah, but not every, well, most, some things I've seen.
For me, I don't know. I'm a bit, yeah, about it. I don't know, cause I don't know what other means. Do they tell us what the others are, or must you like?
I just know anxious and now secure. And it's interesting that the only one that was mentioned in mine was secure.
Was secure, yeah.
Was one mentioned in yours?
It just says, and people tend to be securely attached. People tend to be less anxious and more satisfied. I feel like for me, when it says like easy time forming connections, I know like I form connections very easily, even like with friends and stuff. Like if we just like the same things, it's very easy for me to form a connection with people, because I don't like people, I just like people I like, you know. So
this is true.
So I feel like, yeah, I do form connections easily. I do have an easy time reaching out to people for help. There's a time I used to bottle things up, where something would happen, I would take it and just be like, okay, I'll take it, I bottle it up until it explodes. So I realized there's a problem with bottling things up, because when they explode really badly, and
yeah.
It's like a really difficult situation to deal with, because now you're not dealing with just one thing. It's things that have accumulated over like a long period of time. It can be years, it can be months, it can be days, but at the end of it, you're dealing with something that if you had dealt with each of the situations individually, it wouldn't be as bad. But since you had not, now they're all over. They're looking at you like, okay, what are we going to do now? Your intentions.
I think secure means you know yourself. Something
probably
like that.
It could.
I think that's
right?
What I understood from it.
It could mean that. Because for me, I also know, like, for instance, I know there's things I know about. Like, I know how I want to be loved. And I know that how I want to be loved might not be how other people receive love. So it's also important for me to know how other people receive love. So knowing how your people like to receive love as well is like really important, because then you get to be there for them when they need to be reminded that there's people who love them. Also, I make a point of telling people I love them. The people I love, my friends, I make a point of reminding them, because sometimes we walk around thinking everyone knows they're loved. And it's nice to hear it. For me, it's because I know I love hearing it. Me, I love hearing that I'm loved. So if I like hearing it, my assumption is that other people like hearing it as well. It's not, this is not like a set in stone thing where
yeah.
It's like, oh, I'm always secure. Oh, you're always anxious. No, you also have those moments where you are like secure, unsure. Where you're like, oh yeah, I'm very, you feel like whatever they say, or the others, because I'm sure there are more than,
yeah.
Let me
like
see,
like there's always, it's always,
what are the others out there?
Not the bits.
So there's secure, dismissive avoidant, anxious preoccupied, fearful avoidant, also known as disorganized.
How come secure is the only one on its own?
Because this one's, I think the other ones are also like broken down, they can mean one or the other. Okay, securely attached, Lily. Oh, they're using How I Met Your Mother to explain the different styles on this particular article. So if you've watched How I Met Your Mother, quirky, blah, blah. Okay. When a person has a secure attachment style, they feel confident in their relationship and their partner. They feel connected, trusting, and comfortable with having independence and letting their partner have independence, even as they openly express love. They reach out for support when they need it and offer support when their partner is in distress. So this is dismissive avoidant. It says people who have the dismissive avoidant attachment style tend to be very emotionally independent, perhaps overly so. They find it uncomfortable to get too emotionally close to others or to trust them fully. In fact, those around them may describe them as actively trying to avoid closeness. They seem to pride themselves on not needing emotional intimacy. When they're rejected or hurt, they tend to pull away.
Trauma.
Number three, anxious preoccupied, which I guess is the one, the anxious one. I guess this for this one, for this site, it says anxious preoccupied. People with this attachment style tend to crave emotional intimacy even when their partner is not yet ready for the situation or the situation doesn't call for it. They need a lot of approval, responsiveness, and reassurance from their partners. They can get anxious when they don't get it. It's not fun to have this attachment style. Often people like Ted from that show feel dependent on others for approval and doubt their self-worth. That's only reinforced when the target of their clinginess never seems to be as interested. Yeah.
Rough.
Then the last one is disorganized, which is also known as fearful avoidance. This is why a person with this attachment style is confused. They essentially have both the dismissive and the anxious styles combined. Both want emotional closeness and also push it away. They are fearful of fully trusting others. And yet, they need approval or validation. They often deny their feelings or are reluctant to express them. At the same time, they are more easily jealous and tend to perceive greater threat from possible romantic rivals. In real life, people who have experienced loss or trauma are more likely to have a fearful, avoidant attachment style. For example, children growing up with parents with alcoholism are more likely to be fearful, avoidant. This makes sense because they live in an environment where security and closeness are not guaranteed, and sometimes there is active harm coming from the person who should be taking care of them. These mixed messages lead them to the fearful, avoidant patterns of both reaching out and pulling away.
Wow, that's
interesting. That's very interesting. So, what do you think of the other whatever? Did you feel anything in those ones that you also feel like, okay, I also feel a hint of that in this?
I guess a little bit on the secure part. There's a little bit of that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I guess it does make sense that it's there's a little bit of
you can be a bit of everything.
Yeah, because I know there was a time when I was fearful, avoiding, like way back, with some other relationships. So I can see how you can end up in all of them.
Mm.
It's just based on where you are currently in life.
And also who you're with.
And who you're with.
Yeah. Have you learned something new?
A lot. Find out about your attachment style. It might shed some light on something.
Yeah. Plus, also this stuff is always just, especially if you're someone who's confused about how or why they do certain things, it can be a good, okay, I feel like I've disappeared and only my head is being seen.
It's cold.
I know. Anyway, I was saying that it can assist you in figuring out why or how, why you do certain things the way you do them. Especially if you're someone who's confused and you're always like, why do I always do this? Why do I always do that? It doesn't mean that that's like the ultimate like answer, but it can help you shed light or investigate. It can help you investigate those things and maybe understand yourself a little bit better in a way. So thank you so much for watching this video. We hope you learned something new.
Learn something new every day.
Yeah, and I hope you're going to try and take that quiz and see if you're interested at least. It's simple, takes a couple of minutes, and be honest. You can choose to use it like maybe in your current relationship, your previous one about how you felt, because you can realize like how you reacted differently in like different relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, tell us in the comment section. We want to know what your attachment style is and what you learned about yourself, or if you did it and you're like, that's the complete opposite of what I am. You can also leave that in the comment section as well, because we appreciate just seeing how it worked out for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and like, I don't know, they call it a science. I don't know what it is. It's a blog. Yeah, it's a blog online. So, again, shaming you into subscribing. Because you've watched this video till this part. Now who just subscribed? I love you want to lie to yourself that you're not a part of this family. You've watched until this point. This long. You have stayed. For this entire time. And this is not even your first video. Eh? Stop lying to yourself. It's okay. You've been accepted. Come in. Inkia, darling, darling, darling. We accept you. And it is free. Subscription, ni bure. No one is charging you. You won't be charged for anything. So, yeah. Do the thing.
Peace in the Middle East. Till the next video.
Yes. And everywhere in between. Bye. Hey. Anyway. I feel like I want to make Uji. But at the same time, I'm like...
the stuff for Uji, though.
Oh, I was supposed to buy that yesterday and I forgot. Ah.